Hey everyone, today I'm back in Destiny 2 with a solo flawless completion of the newest dungeon that came out about a week or two ago at this point. So I'll first go over the build that I used in case you want to use the loadout that I used for my completion, and then I'll leave you with the rest of the gameplay. So for this one I'm going to be on my Warlock. Now I hadn't played my Warlock in a while, so my stats are kind of all over the place. The main thing that I did was I wanted to get 100 resilience, and I just took the rest of the stats kind of as they were. For the subclass, I'll be using Well of Radiance because it's just so good on both of the boss encounters. Abilities, I'll be using Phoenix Dive in the gameplay, but that was mainly because I just wanted to try it out. I hadn't played Warlock really since the rework of Solar 3.0, so I wanted to see how Phoenix Dive felt, because I felt like I wasn't really using my Rift all that much, because this is my second solo completion, but it's the first one that I did flawless. But I didn't really feel like I was using my Healing Rift that often, so I kind of wanted to try out Phoenix Dive. Honestly, just stick to Healing Rift, it is the better choice. Using Strafe Glide, Celestial Fire, because I believe it is the stronger melee of the two in terms of the damage output that it has, and then Fusion Grenades, because I will be using these for damage on the final boss encounter. Aspects, using Icarus Dash, because I just like the airborne dash that you have, and then also Touch of Flame for the improved grenades. For the fragments, you shouldn't copy what I'm doing here, because I learned today that this actually does not work when you are solo, so I am using Ember of Torches to make myself radiant, and then I thought, if I become radiant, I get all of this regen for my abilities, but it doesn't work when you're alone, so you could take this one still if you want to, swap this one out for something else. Running this for the resilience, and then I'm running this to get my melee back faster whenever I scorch targets, and I'll be scorching targets a lot because I am running an incandescent submachine gun. So for the weapons then, running this one, I've got Wither Horde, and then I have Cataclysmic with 4x the charm bait and switch for the first boss, and I'm running a Demolitionist rocket launcher for the second boss. Also it's lasting impression, so that's kind of nice. Of course, the reason why this is so good is because of the weakened clear mod that we have, so I can reload my rocket launcher by using my Wither Horde, and then also from the grenade spam that I have with Demolitionist, so it all works together quite well. For the mods themselves, nothing too special. Got Harmonic Siphon on my helmet, because I do feel like you want some orb generation to get your super back faster, because the final boss can have very fast DPS phases back to back, so that's where Harmonic Siphon is going to be helping out a bit. Outside of that, just Ammo Finder. Here I have a Scavenger mod. Outside of that, literally nothing special. On the chest piece, I would recommend you take Concussive and Void. If you do have Artifice armor, then you can also slot in this one from the Artifact this season. But if you don't, then just put in Concussive and Void. That is going to help you out just plenty. I do have Elemental Ordnance and Melee Wellmaker, but they're only fueling into Well of Life to get myself more HP regen, and then also to just regenerate my abilities a little bit. Nothing too special about that. Of course, this season we also have Solo Operative, so take that one as well. It cuts down the DPS phases by quite a bit, and it also helps you kill the normal trash enemies quite a bit faster as well. This is a really powerful mod, definitely recommend you use that one. This is the loadout that I'll be running for the majority of the dungeon, but when I go into a DPS phase, I will be switching it out like this so that I can have Starfire Protocol, which is going to allow me to spam those grenades. So that's basically why I'll be switching it out like that. The final boss gives you a lot of time to switch between your armor, so you definitely have enough time to just quickly open up your inventory and switch these two armor pieces around. So that is going to do it for the build that I will be using in the video. I'll now leave you with the rest of the gameplay. Enjoy.
An old acquaintance among the hidden tells me that a Seraph complex recently powered on for the first time since the collapse. Shortly thereafter, Vex incursions were reported. Anna flagged the site as a potential pillory bunker. If the Vex gain access to its systems, they'll use it to wrest Rasputin submine data away from us. It would be catastrophic.
Landed at the source of the complex's arc supply. Centuries in Martian rust have done this place no kindness. Our window of opportunity is short. Arc surges destabilize the complex, and Vex are breaching the command matrix. Go. Outside the Black Garden. They're a fanatical sect of programming devoted to the darkness, or rather the witness. The Ishtar Collective in a Seraph complex. Peculiar. They were rivals in the Golden Age. This wasn't just a pillory site, it was a joint research facility focused on extrasolar colonization efforts. The Sol Divisive have been scouring research logs. They were looking for something more than to imprison Rasputin's submines. Information stored here, but could it be linked to my visions? Why else would the witness be interested in these files? complex mine remains in this terminal like an open door. It's using the tower's arrays to connect with installations across Sol. This must be in preparation to imprison the submines. Breaking their connection could end this threat. driving the reactor core to a meltdown. It's going prompt critical. Those power surges were intentional. Get to the reactor, lest we lose everything. Guardian, what we've seen here proves my visions have merit. We must secure the complex to convince Ikora. Trust is a frail thing. As much as our mission, if this can restore her faith in me, I need this. Mine directs power to the reactor. Kill it, and the complex should stabilize. clever incision by the Witness. A multi-front attack. Sabotage us, glean knowledge, and annihilate any trace of advantage. Extrasolar colonies. Ages ago, Saint and I thought we'd leave the city once we'd made it safe. We'd explore the universe. That time never came. A matter of finite seconds lost in the margins then. Now, there's only the want of more. But we learn to make do, young wolf, and turn the edge of defeat into victory.